أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله أوله وآخره على نيته وسره اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا اللهم لك الحمد بالإيمان ولك الحمد بالإسلام ولك الحمد بالأهل والمال والمعافى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولد وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها سواء لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم عليه وعلى آله وعلى صحبه وعلى من سار على هديه واستنى بسنته واقتدى بقدوته إلى يوم الدين اللهم آمين أما بعد Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the worlds. O Allah, we praise you and we thank you and we testify to your oneness. And we testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may the peace and the blessings of Allah be upon him, is his prophet and his messenger. He delivered the message, he fulfilled the trust, and he left us in a clear path. No one deviates from this path, except those who are destined to lose in this dunya and lose in the hereafter. May Allah protect us from them. My brothers and sisters, I remind you to observe the taqwa of Allah. Taqwa is piety. Taqwa is the love of Allah. Taqwa is God consciousness. Taqwa is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullaha wal tanzur nafsun ma qaddamat lighad. Wattaqullaha innallaha khabirun bima ta'malun. O you who believe, be God conscious and let soul sees what it has prepared for tomorrow. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of what you do. Amma ba'd. Inshallah Rabbil Alameen, in the few minutes that I have with you today, I want to talk about a few ayat from Surah Al-Ahzab. The last, actually two ayat from Surah Al-Ahzab. Surah Al-Ahzab chapter 37, I believe. And those are the last ayat where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna aradna al-amanata ala al-samawati wal-ardi wal-jibal. Fa'abayna an yahmilnaha wa ashfaqna minha. وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا ليعذب الله المنافقين والمنافقات والمشركين والمشركات ويتوب الله على المؤمنين والمؤمنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما Let's see how much we can do inshallah from those ayat. The rough meaning with a quick translation of those meanings of those ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we have presented the trust, we'll talk inshallah in detail, what is the trust? We have presented the trust up to the heavens, the earth, and the mountains. But they couldn't, and they refused to carry it. وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ Yet the human being, and the human being, carried that trust. وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ Most certainly, he is ظَلُوم Usually translated as a person of transgression, right? We'll also get the true meaning of ظَلُوم وَجَهُولَ He was all the human being is also not knowledgeable enough. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا لِيُعَذِّبَ اللَّهُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ The purpose of this سموها لام العاقبة هذه ليعذب لتكون العاقبة.
The purpose of this presentation of this trust upon the heavens, of the trust to the heavens and the earth, so that at the end, that the conclusion will be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring punishment to المنافقين والمنافقات, the hypocrites from among the males and the females, and والمشركين والمشركات, and the polytheists from the males and the females. And this kind of, usually you don't find the ayah a lot talk about males and females except in these type of things, right? وَيَتُوبَ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also will have tawbah, repentance upon the believing men and the believing women. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the Ghafoor, Ar-Rahim, Ar-Rahim. That's the rough interpretation in those ayat. Inshallah we'll go in details with it. So let's start. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةِ. عَرَضَ, right, is to present. When I present you with a gift, I say I present, you know, that's really a present. I give you a gift, عَرَضْتُ الْجِفْتَ عَلَيْكَ. I give you the gift. When you put your car, when you put your key in the car to turn on, that's really عَرَضْ. You present your key to the car. That's really the essence of it, عَرَضْ. So that's what the word عَرَضْ. إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا, we have presented. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, here it is. الْأَمَانَة, the word from أَمِنَة, which means trust. We all know at our core exactly what trust really means. Trust, trust is when you have the ability to receive something, you understand that you received it, an ability to fulfill and give it back. That's usually a trust. Best thing is just throw an example. Well, brother, I'm going to travel. Can I leave this 1,000 with you as an amanah, as a trust? Right? So the person has to make, oh, he has, the person who's receiving this, first of all, he has to receive the amanah. He has to be able to comprehend that, oh, I'm holding this money. Which means I have to have knowledge what I'm doing, and have the ability to hold it. Because yeah, I'm securing, right? I know a place in my house and under the blanket, whatever you want to do to store that money. And when I come back, you should be able to fulfill back and give me this amanah. So it has these three core components when we talk about trust: comprehension, ability to understand what's going on, right? Ability to say yes, I want to be able to do it, and ability to fulfill. Because if you're traveling as well, you don't want to be taking that amanah. You have to make a choice. You're making a choice to accept the amanah. So that's really at the core what amanah is. Now if you look at the books of the tafsir, they went all over the place trying to interpret what amanah is, right? But at this core, that's what it's for. That's what it is. It is the ability for you to, somebody grants you something, you hold on to it, and ability to fulfill your responsibilities towards it. Now, because of the lack of time, I'm not going to give you all the examples they gave, because they gave a lot of examples, right? They can say that siyam is amanah, right? And you know, hajj is amanah, salah is amanah. But really the general meaning is all the obligations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala required from us is considered amanah. Why? Because it fits the criteria. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let's take the salah for example. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حافظوا على الصلاة الوسطى. Right? إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَقُوتًا. You have to establish the salah. Okay? You're now you're receiving this amanah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have the intellect to understand how to perform your salah? Yes. You know exactly what time you're supposed to perform your salah? Yes. You know how to do it? Yes. So now you fulfill two of them. Then at the time of the salah, you stand up and you perform your salah. It is, you perform your amanah. So the obligations is following in the amanah. And that's the consensus of the majority of the scholar. Amanah here means the ability to perform the duties and the responsibilities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put on your shoulders. Right? That's amanah. Because even in the Quran, if you look at especially the salah, which is an amazing, beautiful way, in Surah Maryam, after he talked about all the prophets, he concludes, فَخَلَفَ مِن بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُ الصَّلَاةِ. A generation came behind them who have lost their prayers. See, you see how the Quran uses the terminology lost? Because if you miss your salah, if you miss your Fajr prayer, you lost it. You can make it up, but that's not the salah of Fajr. That's it, you lost it. Like me, I give you $1,000 and you lose it. That's it. Right? You can try to make up something, oh Allah brother, I don't have it, let me come and work for your house, let me go clean up. You're trying to make up for it, but that's it, you lost it. فَالْأَمَانَ here is the responsibilities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gave the human beings. Now back to the ayah. إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَ. Allah says, we have presented this trust, the ability to take all the earth, be khalifa on the earth, right? To be the vicar, the trustee of earth, take care of the earth, do what you're supposed to do as a human being on earth, right? We have presented that to the heavens, as-samawat, wal-ard, the earth, and the mountains, even though the mountains are part of the earth. But this just to show you the significance of these creations of Allah. فَأَبَيْنَ أَن يَحْمِلْنَهَا. Abba, from the word, they couldn't, they refused to do it. Now, some scholars, again, some of them weren't really, you know, interpretation that's probably not even, yeah, you have to go that, those side of it, like Allah has gave them a soul and they thought about it and said, we don't want to do it. That's not, you don't need to go that far. Because Abba means you're unable to fulfill those three responsibilities. That's what Abba is, right? You're standing over here, you push a wall, right? Will he be able to push it? No, right? He cannot. Abba an yandaka, dafa'atul haqiqa, fa'abba an yandaka. I pushed the wall, but he could not do it. Why? Because he does not have the ability to be pushed. Right? It doesn't have the ability inside. So when we say as-samawat wal-ard abat, not necessarily that it has a soul and him and refuse, it just is not equipped to handle the responsibility. The samawat wal-ard is not created to carry the responsibility. Right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying this to show you how significant the human being is. Something you're carrying that the heavens and the earth and the mountain couldn't carry. That's the essence of the verse. Inna aradna al-amanata ala al-samawati wal-ardi wal-jibal. All this big, huge creation. Is there anything bigger than this universe? And they cannot do it. They're not equipped to do it. وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانَ. Ah, this is actually, let's skip one word. فَأَبَيْنَا أَنْ يَحْمِلْنَا وَأَشْفَقْنَا مِنْهَا. Not only they couldn't, right? أشفق. شفق is, the word means something that is loose, something that is weak, something that is you know, has not much ability. You know the reddish thing after sunset, if you look in the sky, that reddish color, in Arabic called shafaq. Why? Because the color red is not solid red. It's that loose color that is so weak and, you know, fainted and all that stuff, right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, not only those things, the heavens and the earth and the mountains couldn't carry it, they became weak in front of it. This reminds us of the other ayah from Surah Al-Hashr. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. Have we revealed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, had we revealed this Quran upon a mountain, you would find it weak, trembles down from the khashya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the majesty and the fear of the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A verse comes to the Quran, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَرْقُودًا. How is the mountain going to do prayer? Right? وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حُجُّ الْبَيْتِ. How is the mountain going to do hajj? And the mountain knows it is a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You must fulfill it. That's why it would have crumbled in front of it. You see the significance? You, the human being, has that capability. إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ. They're not equipped. They couldn't do it. They are not able to do it. فَأَبَيْنَا أَن يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَأَشْفَقْنَا مِنْهَا. And they became weak in front of it. وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ. Now there's two ways to look at it. You could say, the man came and carried it. You see what I'm saying? The man came and carried it. Or you could say, وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ. And the human being carried it. You see the gestures, how it makes a difference in that? It is the second. It's not like a human being, okay, I'll carry it. No, that's not what it means. This aman is so heavy, the one who's honored to carry it, حَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ. And the human being is the one who was able to take on that responsibility. This ayah, not as many people interpreted, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is demolishing the human being. It's the exact opposite. This ayah is lifting the human being. Allah created this creation. Right? It's not just to say, you're bad creation. No, the opposite. Allah created this man to be Khalifa fil ard, right? To be a vicegerent, a trustee on earth. And he's saying, you have all that to carry the amana. We are the creation of Allah that the angels were commanded to bow down to. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ. When the human being is choosing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, choosing the deen of Allah, he elevates himself in states that the angels themselves cannot arrive to. I mentioned this in a different measure, sure, this measure, I mentioned, right? When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went with Jibreel alayhi salam in the journey of Isra wal Mi'raj, they got to appointed to heavens. Jibreel stopped. He said, I cannot go any further. But you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you can get closer. Come on. Even Jibreel couldn't go. But the human being, when he fulfills the amanah, when he fulfills carrying that trust, the obligation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do not follow, behave correctly, stay away from the haram, help humanity, support your brothers, do all that stuff, you elevate yourself high. That is wa hamala al-insan. The human being can carry on that amanah. So this ayah by no means to bring down the human being. This ayah by no means to lower the value of the human being, is exactly the opposite. This ayah is about telling humans, you are so good that the heavens and the earth and the mountains cannot do what you can do. And this is, brothers and sisters, the message that we have to take to humanity. We have people worshipping cows in parts of the world. We have people worshipping the dollars. We have people completely leaving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have people who are shooting each other in the streets to help them for $5 in their wallets. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, why are you bringing yourself down to this lowest of the low? And if you carry this amanah, you are the one who have been given everything to carry this trust. You understand? You follow me? You have what can elevate you to the highest rank of heavens. And you choose to shoot a human being for $5. You choose to take a bribe for $10. You choose to do this haram and that haram. And you have been granted this, what the heavens and the earth has not been granted before. إنا عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملنها وأشفقن منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. Most certainly the human being is ظلوم. What is ظلوم? ظلوم is what we call صيغة مبالغة. It is an excessive form of the verb ظلم. And most lost translate the word ظلم to transgress. But really ظلم, ظلم at its core is when you are not able to fulfill your responsibilities. That's false transgression. So, example, you hire an employee, you contract with him to work 8 hours, and say, I'm gonna pay you this amount of money, and the employee works 6 hours. Did he fulfill his responsibility? He's able, and he agrees to that contract. That's dhulm, because he did not fulfill what he has, what he's capable of doing. Now, if you ask him to work 24 hours a day, that's dhulm from your side, because he cannot handle it, he has to go to sleep. Your capability, I can work 8 hours, that's within my capability, then I agree, then I will do the 8 hours. So every time you don't do 8 hours, you're 6 and 5 and 4, that is dhulm, right? There is this beautiful verse in Surah Al-Kahf, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the two men and their garden and all that stuff. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing the garden. He says, you know, it has the river between them and all the stuff. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كِلْتَ الْجَنَّتَيْنِ آتَتْ أُكُلَهَا وَلَمْ تَظْلِمْ مِنْهُ شَيْئًا. Both of the gardens gave all the possible fruits they supposed to produce and did not do any dhulm. How is the Jannah, the garden, commit dhulm, transgression? Because exactly the same core meaning. Meaning, if the ability of the tree to produce 100 fruits, it gave exactly 100 fruits. Imagine that, this man, when he walked into this garden, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described it in that picture, every tree in that garden gave exactly what it can handle. Nowadays, when you look at the trees with all the flowers on them, come summertime, there's only 5 fruits. It had all these flowers, where did they go, right? That, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described, the trees gave exactly what they can handle. Imagine the branch, it could carry 10, carry 100, it gave exactly 10 or 100, whatever it's supposed to. لَمْ تَظْلِمْ مِنْهُ شَيْئًا. I mean, it stood up exactly to deliver exactly what it's capable of doing. That's what dhulm is. Now back to the ayah. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. The human being, ظَلُوم, he is not delivering based on his capabilities. Just to reaffirm what we talked about. Allah gave you this. Allah gave you the intellect. Allah gave you the energy. Allah gave you the power. But you are ظلوم, you are not delivering based on all the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to you. We see the man now in the highest office of the man, and now he is transgressing against the Palestinians. He's in the highest of the land, office of the land, and rather than spreading a word of justice, a word of truth, he's insulting people over Twitter. ظلوم! You have all the abilities to rise up, and you choose not to deliver based on this ability you have. You have ability to have a brain, to think, to worship, to deliver, to create, and you choose to go to drugs. Waloom! You do not deliver. That is transgression, and always transgression against yourself. Because you can do this, but you're choosing not to do it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that human being, not just sometimes, constantly waloom. Again, this verse, brothers and sisters, is not about putting down the human being. Rather than us to open our eyes to understand who we are, understand the capabilities that we have and how much we can grow. And also be careful, when I created you, I created in a way that you are, with all the potential you have, you might not be able to do it. So be careful of that. So every day struggle and strive to become a better person, a better person, a better person. That's what this verse is talking about. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. The human being is also jahul. Another form, sigha mubalagha, excessive form of the verse of jahl. And what is jahl? The opposite of knowledge. It's ignorance. And it's exactly the same meaning. The human being does not know that. Most people do not know that. Most people are living like animals out there. All what I need is just my food, my drinks, my desires, and that's it. They do not know that you have been created for a purpose that can lift you above the angels. Jahud. And again, this ayah is not about to admonish the human being. It's not about to bring us down. It's about to open our eyes to see what we can become. To see like how the prophets have became, how the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam have became. When they accepted to really fulfill and carry this amanah forward. Beautiful ayat and reminders to us that you are so powerful as a person, as a man or as a woman. And you see that later in the ayat, he mentioned the males and the females. Because your capabilities as a man are different than the capabilities of a woman. But both of them are superior to the other creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Superior to the creation of the heavens and the earth and the mountains. You have that with you. And then you go, you know, insult somebody with words because of his language or his origin or his skin color or whatever it is. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. That brain and that intellect that you have, you use it to utter bad words and utter bad things and say bad things and commit wrong things. The intellect that you have, that you're supposed to be a khalifa of the earth, you create bombs to destroy things. Balloon. إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ فَأَبَيْنَ أَنْ يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَأَشْفَقْنَ مِنْهَا وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. In the conclusion, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, why Allah have created this? What is your master plan of this? What's the results out of this? ليعذب المنافقين والمنافقات والمشركين والمشركات. The conclusion of this, when people who have the ability to carry, they have the ability to make the choice to carry, as we said in the example when we said the khutbah, you make the choice to carry this thing, right? And carry it correctly, right? And there's people who are choosing the wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, at the end, the results of this, munafiqeen, hypocrites, who are showing some aspect of iman, and in the heart is rotten as, you know, rotten as a fruit that has been, went bad. The hypocrites from the men and the women. والمشركين, the polytheists, from the men and the women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised them with punishment. At the end of this, at the end of this whole thing, summary of this, you have the amana, you carry it. Those who are carrying it in just from the outside just to show off, or those who completely reject it, the conclusion of that, they will receive the punishment. Because you've been given something big. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. And when you choose not to do that, ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. Then we will bring the human being to the lowest of the low. Because you made a choice not to follow, not to carry this amanah. You made a choice where it's in your own fitrah to do the right things, and you do the wrong things. You made a choice when it's in your own fitrah to tell you that no, that you do not like anybody to lie to you, yet you are telling the lies all day long. When you made a choice, it's in your own fitrah that you do not want anybody to steal from you, that you're stealing from everybody else. It's in your own fitrah that you do not like anybody to insult you, yet you are on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook insulting people crazy. You made the choice. You made the choice to go to the lowest of the low. You made the choice not to fulfill the amanah. I gave you the amanah that will lift you up. I gave you a brain, an intellect, a path that goes exactly with your fitrah. Lying is bad, you don't want anybody to lie to you, then lying is haram. You don't want anybody to steal from you, then stealing is haram. You don't want anybody to harm you, then harming others is haram. It goes exactly with what show you were to be. And yet you choose to go against all of that, against your intellect, against your own fitrah, against your own creation, to do the wrong things. Then go down to the lowest of the low. لِيُعَذِّبَ اللَّهُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ. That's the category of people who's going to get lost. And the other category, وَيَتُوبَ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have repentance, tawbah, to the believing men and the believing women. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that the human being, he is dhaloom, he is jahool, he is ignorant, he will commit the wrong things. But those who are struggling every day to be better people, they're not perfect. That's why there is tawbah. We're not perfect, he's going to forgive those sins. But do not be among the hypocrites who completely rejected Allah but only showing iman from the front. Do not be like the mushrikeen who completely rejected Allah from the front and from the heart. Be among those who are believing in Allah. Recognize that you are weak. Recognize that you have so much power that you are not able yet to stand up for it. That is okay. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the caravan of the believers. The caravan of people who carry these things. Yeah, you know it's lying is haram, but you lied. Ya Allah, astaghfirullah. Wallahi, that was wrong. That was wrong from me. Astaghfirullah. Come back to it. You did something haram. Istighfar. Repentance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that we're not perfect. That's why there is tawbah. If this ayah, there is no liyatub Allahu ala al-mu'mineena wal-mu'minat, we will be in trouble. Because there is no way that we can do ibadat and obedience to Allah to compensate the blessing that He has given us. There's absolutely no way. There's no count. You know the hadith of the eye and being put in the scale. There's no way that you can do all your salah, all your siyam, all your help to others and all that will never compensate one of the blessings of Allah upon you. We will always be sure. And the answer is, Allah says, don't worry about it. He will have tawbah on you. What's the difference then, Ya Allah? Because there's two categories. There's people who's going to go to the hellfire, and there's people who's going to go to Jannah. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازَ. The Quran says, he who is inched away, moved away, rescued away from the hellfire to the Jannah, he succeeded. That's it. Now in Jannah, you will find different levels. There's people who just enter Jannah, and there is Al-Firdaws Al-A'la. And that's where you decide from your repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you want to be among at least the people who enter the Jannah. يَتُوبُ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. For He subhanahu wa ta'ala, غَفُور, conceals and protects you from the effects of the sins. I ask for His compassion subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the best of understanding. أَقُولَ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عبد الذي اصطفى نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. عباد الله, beautiful ayat that we ourselves have to understand what it means to us, because I talk to all of Christians, I talk to other people, I talk to atheists, nobody that I've talked to, absolutely nobody, that they have teachings in their own core faith that elevates the human being to the status more than Islam. Nobody. In their faith, they're teaching them that the woman is pregnancy as punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rather being a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You convince Adam to eat from the tree, Allah will punish you. We don't have that in Islam. What we have in Islam is this, You are the best of the creation. سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. This ayah is just astonishing. Allah says, everything in the heavens and the earth, سَبَعْ سَمَاوَاتِ, everything for you, the human being. Imagine that. And you nowadays find people just competing and killing each other over a dollar and fighting all this stuff. Nobody can elevate man as a human to this state more than Islam. This is something to be proud of. This is something to be thankful for. They talk to us, you know, from all different groups. I'm like, why are you inviting me? You're inviting me to be a Christian so I could follow, to bring myself to the lowest of the low? Where I have the religion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you are the best of the creation. This is the deed that tells me that I can be higher than the angels. If I decide to choose Allah, if I decide to obey Allah, if I decide to worship Allah, you'll be higher than the angels. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ. You just have to make the right choices. Don't go to the lowest of the low. That's something that will affect you as a person. When you are making your salah, you know I'm making it to elevate myself up. We're coming up to the month of Ramadan, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. This is the month to elevate yourself up by making those choices. When you go outside and you see people and they're poor and all that stuff, you say, Alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-Islam. This is, thank you, Allah, that I'm a Muslim. You see the people doing drugs under a bridge here or something like that. You thank yourself. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and, you know, that he gave you a better way of life. This is the deen. This is when we say the Quran has everything for us. Yes, it has everything. He told us who we are, and he told us how, you know, our own creation, so that we understand who we are and so that we can behave better and we become better people. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the best of understanding. عباد الله إني داعٍ فأمنوا من بعدي اللهم اغفر المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا مولانا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا وتقبل منا واقبلنا يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا وجلاء همومنا وذهاب همومنا وأحزاننا، واجعله لنا في الدنيا دستورا وفي القبر مؤنسا ويوم العرض عليك شفيعا يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله وأقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
استقيم الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تكونوا كالذين آذوا موسى فبرأه الله منهم وكان عند الله وجيها. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم
ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. إنا عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملنها وأشفقن منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. ليعذب الله المنافقين والمنافقات والمشركين والمشركات ويتوب الله على المؤمنين والمؤمنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين. لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون. فما يكذبك بعد بالدين أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Jazakumullah khair, Brother Badawi, for beautiful deliberation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from him, inshallah, and for all of us. Brother, we do have pizza. Please do not go without having a pizza lunch, inshallah, and make dua for those brothers who are providing pizza for every Friday, inshallah. May Allah keep them blessing and barakah and khair on their family, their business, inshallah ta'ala. We do not have our youth corner tomorrow after Maghrib. However, we have our regular maktab from 9 to 1, inshallah ta'ala. And also, we have art workshop tomorrow after Zuhr prayer, always to 3 o'clock, 3:30, inshallah ta'ala. If you have children age 7 and up, please do bring them, inshallah ta'ala. They will know how to draw, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair.
Assalamu alaikum. The Islam 101 class will be for the non-Muslims this coming Saturday, the 8th, not this Saturday, the one after that. Saturday the 8th, inshallah, February 8th, at the North Palestine Muslim Community Center. If you have friends or neighbors or colleagues who just about Islam, it's a good session for you, inshallah.